Hi everyone, my name is Karla Gonzales Garcia. I am the policy director for the Colorado Organization for Latina Opportunity and Reproductive Rights, COLOR. I'm also a proud immigrant from the beautiful country of Peru. And for me, sustaining communities is about my work, my passions, my commitment to protect our immigrant communities, the community that I am part of. Right now, I'm extremely concerned and quite frankly, angry that we had been left out from the conversations that are part of developing guidelines to reopen states and relaxing social distancing. Immigrants have been left out from the resources, from the basic resources to keep ourselves healthy and safe. Many of us have come from countries that have been torn by violence in pursuit to better ourselves, in pursuit to have a better future, free from state violence and hunger. And here we are, left again with concerns if we will be able to make it or not through this health crisis. For many years, advocates had fought constantly, had rallied in order to produce the changes that we need to protect our immigrant communities. We have been fighting for access to healthcare, insurance programs, a social insured program for paid medical and family leave, paid sick days, workplace protections, workers' protections, pregnant people workers' protections, addressing the racial and gender gap, affordable housing, and many other things. And in order to fix the systemic issues, unfortunately, our lawmakers have been keep putting obstacles and obstacles for us to access these basic things. We must not leave anyone behind. We cannot put profits over people. We cannot think that our economy can go and run back to normal, because what runs the economy is people. And if people are not okay, if people are not alive in itself, then we cannot run an economy. So while some legislators or some governors or some council members or the president of this country is trying to figure out ways on how to profit from our bodies, we should not leave that happen. So we are here with a call to action. We are here, call to your city council members, to your congress people, to your governor, to your legislators, and demand to protect our immigrant families, the most vulnerable among us. And in the middle of this all, my people, let's not forget too that even if they are not thinking about us, we need to remember that we are here because our ancestors have seen us being here. We can't forget that our strength comes from a powerful ancestral line. Our teachers, our healers, our parteras, those ancestors that had given their lives for us are here with us. And they are asking us to use that strength, to use our collective power to protect ourselves, our family members, and our community members. Because it is in our collective power that we will be able to go through these times. We will survive by our collective power, by supporting each other. And we will continue the journey, our journey in this line that now we call home. Thank you, everyone.